All right, Jim.
All right, this is another bit, recurring bit. Last topic for today.
Yeah, so Jim's terrible decisions. And
for once, it's not something I bought.
You know, I was going to be on something he bought, but I said, let me throw something else out there. And I'll have to explain it, do some prefacing, but Jim's Twitter responses. And what I mean by that specifically is that Jim runs our Drink a Beer Play Game Twitter. So if you're conversing with Drink a Beer Play Game on Twitter, you're basically conversing with Jim.
Yeah, like 99% of the time.
Yeah. And if you're talking, like the only times I will ever sign on to ours is literally to be like, watch our video on YouTube. Like it's never to answer someone. So when Jim gives answers, if you say like, what's your favorite game of all time? What's this? Or what's your thought on this? You're getting Jim's answers, which are most of the time very terrible. So that's why today's Jim's terrible decisions is his responses. Now, what sparked this, and we won't go too deep into it, without having any context, Jim first put out the photo of Pro Jared and said, this is my new phone screen background.
Being topical, poking the bear.
He was, which I didn't know at the time, because it wouldn't be out of the realm of possible for Jim without... If the Pro Jared thing never happened, how it went down, it wouldn't be out the realm of possibilities for Jim to just put some stupid, silly shit like that up anyway. Like many people's Twitters, I think it's safe to say our Twitter is more or less a billboard for our buddies. Right? Which is normal.
Yeah, we all help each other out and shit. It's a platform for us.
But then Jim throws his sense of opinions on things. So you'll get a lot of random wrestling shit. Drives me fucking nuts because he has his own wrestling Twitter response,
which I never touch any. Well, why don't I use the one with 500 followers when I have one with 10,000 followers?
Exactly, and he's spouting his terrible decision. Like if he's like,
you're just mad that I say Goldust a lot.
That so there you go. So Jim will write things like Goldust. I'm like, I don't want that representing us because they're terrible decisions. And Jim, from our fans, from everyone who watches us, generally makes decisions that no one agrees with, as opposed to some, you know? So I did actually have the list, and I don't know where it is, and I'm really pissed.
Convenient, as if it even exists.
Oh, it does, because I think what I might have to do is keep it reoccurring, and maybe at the end of every podcast, in the credits or something, I'm going to start throwing up Jim's responses.
What did Jim say this time?
Pissed me off. But it was things like, best video game or games you don't like, and shit on games either I do like or putting out games are just fucking awful. Like if he one more time, you son of a bitch, put out there like, oh, my favorite game of all time is Rocket League. You found a game 4 years ago tops, you still suck at it, and you
never said favorite, said it was a perfect game.
Exactly. That pissed me off to no end. It is not a perfect game. It's a fun game.
Perfect game.
And the point is, Jim is also wildly inconsistent because we've had lists on our Excels when we track things of what's our top 10 favorite games. And I've seen Jim answer this thing a million times. And he can't seem to keep his goddamn list straight, even though he's using the same 5 or 6 games, essentially, in his top list. So, yeah, Jim's answers, if you're following our Twitter, don't represent both of us. I think Jim needs to start putting a little asterisk saying, this is Jim. Because Goldust is not a good wrestler.
You're right, he's fantastic.
He's a goddamn, you just like a weirdo.
A character, which wrestling desperately needs these days. Everyone's got one name or they just act like themselves. It's boring. Bangs are in the toilet. You tell me, Bri.
And when Jim...
It was better with Duke the Dumpster.
And obviously, Jim being the nut hanger off of Sega that he is, he'll either always choose that over anything Super NES or shit on Super NES.
As I should.
Or whatever.
I don't shit on Super NES. I just say that it's filled with babies who cried at Final Fantasy VI.
Yet, you managed to nut hug these Japanese-specific Super Famicom ones, and you shit on Final Fight. I can't even say how many times, and now all of a sudden you're Mr. Pro Final Fight for the past couple weeks or whatever it's been.
Streets of Rage is still better.
And I'm like, you hate that game so much, but you're acting like you love it. So,
I don't know if I ever said I hated it.
Oh, you like it's the most boring fucking. Why?
Look, I will say all it has over Streets of Rage is graphics. That's all it has over Streets of Rage. But
and Control.
No.
It does.
No.
The grabbing is way better for the Super NES.
No.
It's way better.
No.
And this is coming from me who likes Streets of Rage better and who's better at it than you. So my point is. We've proven that, Jim.
Nothing's
That's
proven.
Just fact.
Nothing is proven.
Jim, do we need to look in the annals of our archives?
Look, when you take a guy's mane from him.
All I'm saying is...
I still have to do more work.
My point is, stop doing terrible responses, because what was it? There was something you actually put me over the edge. I had to log in and delete your response, because it pissed me off so bad.
I think it was a wrestling one.
Was it? It was something I was like, no, this can't go unchecked.
You bitched about something or
you
other.
You said something. So, for Jim's terrible decisions, this leads me to, in the future, I think I'm going to screenshot things that just drive me nuts.
Go ahead.
And we'll have to start pointing that out. There's a lot of it.
Go ahead. Do what you want.
Fucking Jim.
Numbers don't lie, bro. 10,600 people can...
Hey, Jim, how come that didn't get converted to YouTube?
I don't know. You run that shit mostly.